Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I'm back with another sweet Tinkercad circuits lesson. So let's get cracking. Step one, of course, is to click that little circuits button, and we want to create a brand new circuit. Let's start by naming our circuit. This one's going to be called LCD, and we're going to put our initials after it. The first part we're going to use is the breadboard small from the basics. Click, wait a second for it to show up, and then set it near the top of your board, or build area. The second thing we're going to use today is the Arduino, so scroll down and find your Arduino Uno, drop it in, and then I'm going to ask you to rotate it just because I prefer seeing the numbers closer to the board when we're making the video. Now let's use the search button for the first time and type LCD. Notice it gives us the sweet 16 by 2 LCD, and I'd like you to drop it in just like that. Start a brand new Google tab, and then I'd like you to type LCD code Arduino in the box. We want the Hello World code. Notice the code looks like this, and if we scroll down, we'll be able to find the actual code that we're going to use. Here's a picture of how our board is going to look when we're done, but this is the magic part that we need. Simply select all of that code, right to the last parenthesis, and then copy it. The nice thing about this code is it's going to show us how to build it as well. Click your code choice and switch from blocks to text. Tell it you do want to continue. Select the blocks we're getting rid of, delete those, and then right-click paste to put your new code in. When you're reading code, anything with these slashes in front of them is a comment, and it does not actually do the work. When you get down here where they are dark, that is where it's the actual code that is being used. Let's start with some easy connections. Let's connect the positive rail to the 5 volt, and then to make it so it stays clear, let's make it red. Click either of the grounds and connect it to the negative rail, and once again, making the colors stay clear, let's make that black. Continuing with our positive and negative connections, let's click on the last LED and connect it to the negative rail, make it black. Let's click the negative rail and move it all the way up to the other negative rail so they both have our negative running through it. Let's also click the positive and move it to the positive rail so the electricity is flowing on both sides of our breadboard. If you're looking closely, this one says ground, so obviously we'll connect it to ground as well. And then lastly, let's connect the read-write to the ground and make it black as well. We need two more parts, a resistor and a potentiometer. Let's go back and grab those quickly by simply hiding the code. And then up top, we can clear the little window that has a search. Here is our resistor. This is going to connect to the LCD, so I'm going to go out here to 17 so the line is straight. So there's my positive, and then I'm going to connect a wire down to this LED, and I'm going to make it a funky brown. The color of the wires doesn't matter, it just makes it more clear as we're studying our diagram. Here is our potentiometer. Let's drop it over here with its middle pin over our ground wire. We need to give it some electricity, so connect this positive rail to the first pin. Remember, we just do any of the holes below it. Once again, let's make it red so we can tell that we're sending juice there. Let's connect its last pin to a ground wire. So I'm just connecting straight up. I'm going to make that black so it shows up as ground again. And then let's do one more bit of electricity as we connect the positive rail to our VCC and make it red. We're going to take VO and we're going to move it up and connect it to the potentiometer. Let's make it a funky color. I'm going to go with turquoise because that way it shows up on top of all those other parts. I'm going to bring back my code so you can see where I'm getting these next few connections. So first we're going to do RS to digital pin 12. I'm going to start at the RS, and then this is kind of cool. I'm going to go in between the holes. All right. And then when I click there, it lets me bend it so I can come over to 12. so it just makes it more clear as we build our wires. It's not really in the breadboard, it's just bent. I'm going to make that a funky orange color. And when I click away, look at that, the wire actually bends, pretty sweet. The enable pin goes to 11, that is E, you can hover over it and read the labels. Once again, I'm going to click in the middle and bend it across and connect it to my 11. I'm going to make it a lovely yellow, once again, just so I can see where my wires are going. D4 goes to pin 5, so if we hover over them, there is D4. Number 5 is right here, so once again, I'm going to go up to this middle area, click, and move across. Double checking, 4 went to 5. Trying to keep everything a different color. This time, I'm going to use real blue. Now D5 goes to pin 4. Click, move, click, click. I'm going to stay with green on that one. Next is D6, and D6 connects to pin 3. Let's change that color to purple. And finally, D7 goes to pin 2. I'm going to make this one real short and bring it across because that connects pretty nice. Let's check our colors. We're down to pink. Remember, our resistor is supposed to be a 10K resistor, so let's click on it. Right now, you can see it is a 1K resistor. I will remind you that that is 1 ohm. This is kilo-ohms. And let's put a 0 there, so now it is a 10K resistor. You can also read it because of the labeling where it shows the brown, black, orange. Let's scroll down and check out what's going to happen. When we turn on our simulation, it's going to say hello world if we've done it correctly. Let's hit start and do a quick test and see if we get lights. Now you see it started to glow. This is where you click the potentiometer and adjust the brightness and see if you can get it so it can show up. If you get it to the right spot and you've got your stuff working, you can pat yourself on the back for being awesome. You can see that this code taught it to say hello world, and then it set the cursor to this location, which is 0 over, 1 up, and then it printed the number of seconds since reset. Let's stop the simulation and let's put something different in there. Instead of hello world, I'm going to change that to yo 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 world. And this is where you can experiment and see how many characters you can get to go across and what kind of things can happen like that. When I start the simulation, and again now, there's a pause, and then check it out. There is my yo, yo, yo world. Notice it can do punctuation, which is pretty cool. Note that time since reset, you can just tap the little red button, and it will reset it and start again. Let's stop this code quick, and let's play with this code down below. Instead of seeing it count, which was kind of cool, I want to put a second phrase down here. So I'm going to delete what's in the parentheses, and notice here we had the quotes and our phrase. I'm going to put my own quote on this second line. I'm going to change it to HLModTech rocks, and I'm going to put a quote on it. Notice it's going to do it at 0, 1, which is the second row. And that also emphasizes that you can always read these comments to understand what you're playing with. When we hit start simulation, let's see how it looks at this point. There you are, yo, yo, yo world, HLModTech rocks. Alrighty friends, so there you saw it do 2 lines of text. See if you can explore to make it clear screen, see what you can find. You can use Google to search for the different codes. You can read the comments to find other information to see what you can make happen. Either way, friends, I hope you enjoyed the lesson. If you did, please hammer that like button. If you've got a question, comment, or suggestion, add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit the notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new movie from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.